We all know that we've had 8 increases of a quarter point since 2015. We're now at 2 to 2 and a quarter. So the ongoing tightening process with rates continues. Tomorrow most likely be number 9. But very little talk has been about the balance sheet, which is dripping anywhere from, you know, 40 to 50 billion a month. Went from 4.5 at its peak to about 4.1 trillion now. Do you think the balance sheet tightening is going on stealth but having a bigger outsized impact on the U.S. economy?
Yeah, you know, it's having a bigger impact than the Fed expected, right? At the time they did QE3, they said to people, look, this is going to have an impact. Then when they reversed it and started the taper, it was almost like they're trying to get people to say, no, this is the paint drying, it's not going to matter. And I think it does matter, right? You have the Fed, as you said, going $50 billion a month. You have the ECB stopping their QE, and then China and others kind of hesitating to buy U.S. Treasury. So I think it does matter.
So from a cumulative standpoint, we really started to tip from easy to not easy money in October. My next issue is even simpler. Many now think $3.5 trillion for the balance sheet could be a target. So does that mean balance sheet reduction stops altogether sometime in 2019, 2020?
It sure looks like that. And, you know, look, the Fed has the ability to pay interest on reserves. And so they have the ability to keep a large balance sheet and still have control of the Fed funds rate. They just need to explain it. They need to explain to people, we are going to pay banks not to lend, and explain why they're doing that. But it's, you know, in some sense, from the Fed's perspective, that's okay.
Now, I guess to finish up, Mr. Powell and company may have an issue with communications, the president. I personally don't think so. But in the end, do you think in the near future there's going to be a statement out saying that we may ease off rates and concentrate only on that other tightening of close to $50 billion a month as they try to lead the market to pay attention more to the balance sheet? Is that possible, Phil?
Yeah, I think that's possible because it looks like they're going to hike again, as you said, and do it in a really dovish way. Say, look, we are done. Try to give markets certainty instead of leaving markets hanging for another month. But at the same time saying, look, we are still doing this kind of tightening through the balance sheet.